Hello everyone, thanks for joining in. An exciting day is in front of us as we've got four finals coming up today. Two will be here in the final hall in the International Olympic City shooting range, mixed team events, and two later in the day at the shotgun range, trap individual events. My name is Martina Lucic and I'll be here for you all week long. It's the season opener ISSF World Cup here in Cairo for rifle, pistol, and shotgun 2024, the Olympic year. 6 more months until the grand spectacle of competitions, and athletes have been preparing for it already, and actually this World Cup might be one of the preparation parts for our athletes. The first final of the day is the air rifle mixed team event. We're going to get to see some familiar faces in this final today. Bronze medal match, gold medal match ahead of us. Only single shots today in this final hall, 50 second per shot. You know the drill. Men and women compete together in this event and points are awarded after each round. The higher scoring team wins 2 points after those rounds, and if they're tied, they both win one. First to get to 16 wins the match. I have to say, it's a bit chilly today, and as we were told yesterday, it's not going to be fun for the trap shooters that take their position in the final today in the afternoon. They're going through their qualification right now, and we are heading into the bronze medal match of the mixed team air rifle event. All the competition schedule and results are up on the ISSF web. You can also find it on the ISSF Instagram page, and we're broadcasting live on YouTube and Facebook. Athletes from 66 countries arrive at the season opening competition. I think everyone is well acquainted with the shooting range here. It held World Cups, it held World Championships with quota places being awarded, and World Cup finals as well, and now it's opening the season of the Olympic year, the end of the four-year cycle. Well, actually, in this case, it's 3 years. It's 3 years since Tokyo was in 2021. Some athletes are shooting for ranking points only. That's RPO in short, which means they don't really shoot to end up in the final. And we'll be awarding the Olympic quota after the last ISSF World Cup, which will be in Munich. And that means if they're eligible, if their country still has an empty quota place, and if they're high enough on the rank to get it. But less Olympic talk right now, because we are at the ISSF World Cup Cairo 2024, and we are getting ready for the bronze medal match of the 10-meter air rifle mixed team event. Two teams coming out now. First coming out is the German team, Anna Janssen and Maximilian Ulbricht. They were fourth after the qualification with 630.1. That's their joint score that they had. And ahead of them, 631.4 was Norway. Jeanette Hagdustad and Jon Herman Haag with their coach there. Wasn't a great qualification for them. They lost a place in the gold medal match from Great Britain, not even on the score points, but on the last series that was higher for Great Britain. They're going to show up now, but they will be shooting later in the gold medal match. Great Britain, Shauna McIntosh and Dean Bale. Beating against Great Britain was the team that was at the top of the qualification rank, and that is India. Arjun Babuta and Sonam Maskar. Sonam's first World Cup final appearance. Arjun has been in Cairo already here won the team gold medal at the World Championship 2 years ago. Presenting the officials.
And I can tell you that the chief range officer for this final, as ever, is Mr. Uwe Vogts of Germany.
And we get to see the athletes a bit closer just before they get into the real deal, the action of this final.
World Cup Cairo 2023. We'll be getting started with the bronze medal match first, followed by the gold.
The athletes will have a few minutes just to get into it with the preparation series. Going to be shooting some sighting shots. And that was the presentation. Which means now when they take their stand, they're not going to be moving away from it anymore. Bronze medal match. Once again, Norway and Germany. You're going to have to wait a little bit for the gold medal match and Great Britain versus India for the top place on the podium. They have a minute to settle in. They have 5 minutes for sighting time. Hopefully that is just enough to get in the zone, to get into the center of the target. The target, which 10 is the size of a dot on a paper. And the closer they get to the center of the target, the bigger the decimal after the 10 is. The highest score being a 10.9. And you want to get as close to that as possible each time, even though they're shooting one round at a time. 50 seconds for each shot. That doesn't include the preparation and sighting time. Of course, they can shoot however much they want. Jeanette Hegdestad, 25. She's won many medals here in Cairo at the World Championship, actually, back in 2022. That was a 300-meter rifle three position, and the same competition, she won a bronze medal in the 50-meter 3B. And so did Jon Herman Hegg, actually. They won the same medal. And interestingly enough, they were both fourth at the Tokyo Olympic Games in the 50-meter 3 position, with Destad winning the fourth place in the 10-meter as well. Anna Jansen, only 22. This team here, with Anna Jansen and Maximilian Ulbrich, they won the gold medal at the Rio World Cup in the mixed team event last year.
And the scores from each shot are combined to give a team total. The team with the
here is the coach as well. Anna Jansen. She's won the World Cup final here in Cairo. She's won 5 World Cups in her career. And that's all only in the last 2 years. Two of those medals are individual, but all required finals and all required her to be a good teammate and to have good teammates to be able to end up on the top of the podium. Of course, that's how it goes.
Maybe halt the flow of the final, get a message to their athletes. They can do that. They can call one timeout per team.
Here they are. So a little bit different here with the timeouts, which they don't get into in the individual competitions. So the coach, or well, even the athletes, can ask for a timeout at some point. Here's the chief range officer, Uwe Fuchs from Germany. So they can call for a timeout. Uwe will allow the timeout once, only once. And usually the timeout is a good break if one team is on a roll and the other team really wants to break that streak.
Good morning, Jamie. We're back again.
Here are the announcers for the audience here today. Mr. Amer Abdelazim, here from Egypt. He is translating what the ISSF announcer is saying. Jamie Sangram.
يتحدد بعدها من يحصل على نقطتين نتيجة هذه الطلقة الأعلى في النتيجة الفريق الذي يصل إلى 16 نقطة يحصل على الميدالية.
The athletes have a little over a minute and a half. I guess the two teams are kind of equal, even though Norway almost got in the gold medal match. Dystad and Hag are 25 and 24, while Janssen and Lundberg are 22 and 23. All in their still, I would say, early 20s. These athletes are rocking the seniors event and really, really getting ahead, showing up at the Olympics as well. Anna Janssen. Olbrich actually won the World Cup silver medal last year here in Cairo, and he is still last year's European champion from Tallinn. Cairo's been very good to Jeanette Hegg-Dustad, the 25-year-old. We'll see today in the mixed event with Jon Herman, who's won two golds in the mixed team here in Cairo. Today, opening... opting for a bronze medal. So the Norwegian team is definitely motivated to climb the podium, maybe even a bit more pressured as they fell out of the gold medal match. They were just almost there. But we'll see, at least in the first couple of rounds, who takes the lead. If they're tied, maybe we'll get to see where they're standing in just a couple of moments.
For the first competition start, load. Start.
The action is starting. The first round of the bronze medal match, the first mixed team event of this ISSF World Cup in Cairo, Egypt. We have another mixed team coming up. It's going to be the air pistol, we've seen yesterday as well, starting with a 10.3 from Hegg. Just add a 10.5. I think it's going to be a tough call. Yeah, 0.2 of a difference in favor of Norway. They're taking the first lead. Dystad's won a mixed team event, the European Championship, as well. She's got 6 World Cup golds, one that she won last year in Rio for the 50-meter three position. Both Dystad and Hegg shoot the 50-meter three position, maybe a little bit more, and are just really open to it as they're from Norway, so they've been shooting the 300-meter as well. It's kind of like comes natural to them. 20.7, reachable and definitely doable as Ulbricht hits a 10.7 here and comes to a tie. There's more and more people coming to watch the mixed team event.
صعب.
Aubrey has just had a nice, very close to a bullseye of a 10. Let's see how he continues on in the next round. Jansen hits a 9.9. That might cost them 2 points over here. Yep, taking over the lead, back at it. Norway with 4 points. Yeah, it was a good time in Cairo for Hegg 2 years ago as well, winning the gold in the mixed team event. There are many athletes from Norway who are shooting really, really good, so the mixed teams are not always the same, and Dystad and Hegg are not always in the same team, but today they are, and they're in the bronze medal match. So they're fighting for a place, last place on the podium. They're in the lead. I think they're heading for another 2 points here in this round. Oh, start out into a 9.7. That might, yeah. That might change that plan. 0.1 of a difference only. And 2 points go to Germany. Even though their round wasn't really the strongest of the round, that 9.7 really did have them gained 2 points here. There's that Rio mixed team gold of last year. So Jansen and Ulbricht already found themselves together in a team and at the top of the podium. So they're also eager, I'm sure, to end up on this one as well. Series number 5, the two teams are tied, and I guess they'll be catching each other's tails throughout this bronze medal match. This is a moment for Norway to take the 2 points once again and take over the lead. By now only a 0.1 of a difference. Once again, here's the ISSF president, Mr. Luciano Rossi, right next to the Egyptian president of their federation and the African federation as well, Mr. Hassan Khosni. As we're rolling into series number 6, is Norway going to be able to hold that lead? Or is Germany coming back for a tie? Six to four. 10.3 on the Norwegian side. Not the strongest of the tens. But Dystad came in, redeemed herself with a 10.7. Is that going to be enough to hold the lead, make it even bigger? Yep. 0.2 of a difference. It looks like it's a timeout. Team Germany not really letting Norway get too far ahead. They know that every round counts, every moment counts. Can't let them get into the momentum too far. Something secretive. It's a tactic or a strategy or something. I'm not entirely sure. And they will never tell us, I'm sure. That will never happen. But great marksmen, they don't really share their secrets, which is fair. It's fair. That's for sure. They took a little break. They do have 10 more seconds, but looks like the timeout is over. And let's see if whatever the coach said to Ulbrich and Janssen is going to turn things around and help the team out, as they are currently in a disadvantage of 4 points. Series number 7. Hague into a slim 10. Not a promising score. Janssen in the center of the target. Yep. This definitely did break the momentum of Norway. Germany's able to come to 2 points by a difference of half a point in the score. Norway's halfway there, halfway to 16. That magic 16. This first part of the final is going kind of moving pretty slowly, but as we come to the half to 16, things start getting a bit more tenseful. You can kind of feel it in the air, in the room, that they know they're coming to an end. Four from Hague. Oh, and Janssen into a slim 10. Looks like this is going to be another 2 points for Norway, as they'll be staying in the lead, and Germany doesn't really have a timeout to take anymore. So they just have to push through whatever is happening. Yeah, we can see that blip that Justad had around the 9.7, I think. But then she was back at it once again. She was pretty consistent in the first three shots, hitting that nice 10.5. That's kind of the most stable shot you can shoot. Ten to six. Six to go for Norway, 10 to go for Germany. The trigger pull on a rifle is very, very light. So the athletes kind of find the target. They align the concentric circles of the sight and the target. And once they see a picture they like, they pull the trigger. Hague was able to come to a 10.4 to start 10.2. Didn't really bring a big challenge to Germany, as they shot two great tens, winning 2 points here. They're not letting Norway off the hook. As I said, I think Norway coming in to the final, to the bronze medal match, with a bit more pressure, as they almost made it to the gold medal match. Janssen hasn't been as consistent as Dustad, and the score is showing it. I mean, it's only 2 points of a difference, but still, Norway has been in the lead most of the time in this bronze medal match. on the other hand, I really do think that the differences between these two teams are very, very slim. And well, so are the decimals, and so are the concentric circles that I was telling you about, and the 10 on the paper there. So everything is really in millimeters. That's why these guys have to be wearing all the equipment and the jackets and the shooting trousers and the shoes that are really super tight so that they can be as calm as possible. 10.8 from Dustad. It's going to be another round for Norway. 21.2. Not a bad round for Norway, especially in this moment. So it's all about stability in this discipline. Stability, discipline. I mean, the heart must be beating strongly in the finals, but there's a way around that as well. Surely these super professional athletes have ways to calm the nerves, as they have to be as precise as possible. Stop. 12 to 8. We're at series number 11. Here's Haig. Should say 10.1. His rhythm is the fastest. He does tend to shoot first. Jansen, 10.5. Do start out into a slim 10 as well. This is going to be probably a lost round for Norway. Yeah, Ulrich comes in with a 10.9. They only needed like 9.7 or something like that, but that was a nice 10.9. Now again, of course, there's a timeout. The Norwegians are not gonna let the German team take the momentum, especially not after such a great, strong shot from Ulrich. He's been inside the circle of the 10 for the past, well, for all the shots, actually. They did go into slim 10s, but he's back, actually, in the complete dead center of the target. You can see in the graphics here on the left how it's been going throughout the final. The time is up. 1 minute for a timeout. No more timeouts.
For the next competition, start. Load. Start.
Now the audience is starting to clap, starting to cheer for the athletes standing on the firing line of the finals of the ISSF World Cup in Cairo 2024. The first mixed team event. Haig, again, shooting first, 10.5. Dustad might be the net. That's gonna cost them probably. Yeah, Ulrich back at it. Did not get distracted by the timeout. It's a tie after some time. It's a tie between Norway and Germany at 12 points. Which means things can turn around just as easily. Norway had a comfortable lead there. And now Germany is breathing down their necks. putting pressure on him. Let's see if they can hold it. Gustav had a few of those nines. She'd come back into a center 10. Let's see if she does it again. Hag's gonna shoot first, probably. Janssen, 10.5, already an advantage on German side, but Dusad does redeem herself with a 10.6. Ulbrich. It was almost for Norway. But first time now, Germany taking over the lead, coming to 14, and a match point. They really did push out Norway now. And it's gonna take a lot of strength to come back. The momentum is in, no more timeouts. They were able to overcome that last timeout, and Ulbrich really did give it all, shooting these strong tens. Janssen has had a couple of good shots as well in the last three. Nice 10.5s and even higher than that. So the team, they really were building it up from the beginning. Wasn't super easy. Might be a match point for Germany. Let's see if Norway's gonna allow that to happen. Point two of a difference so far. Norway in the lead. Ulbrich needs a 10.8 for a match point. Shoots a 10.2. No! Norway is not letting Germany off the hook easily. They've come to a tie once again. Now it's series number 14. With the last shot, potential last shot, being the most important one. Yeah, we've seen Hag. He was kind of there in the lower side of the 10, not really going above and beyond, but holding a stable 10. Which came in handy a couple of times. Tied at 14. Match point. Hick might be the first one to shoot. So let's see, a 10.2. Not the strongest of the 10 to wrap things up. 10.7 from Dustad might help out. There's a 10.3 there. Ulbrich needs a 10.7. Is this? Shoots a 10.6. Which means this is the first time, and I said it's a potential last one. This happens with teams who are this close as Norway and Germany. 1 point each. Dragging it out now as they don't want to let us know who's going to be on the podium just yet. .9. That's a good round, but anything above 21 is a great round and usually a winning one. So Now we're ready for the last shot. First to go over 16. Ooh, out to a 9.6. Ulbricht needs a 9.5 here. And a 10.4 wins Germany 2 points and a match point in the bronze medal match. First of the bronze medal matches of the ISSF World Cup in Cairo. Germany takes the bronze. Anna Janssen and Maximilian Ulbricht will be on the podium. Norway was holding it pretty well throughout the whole beginning. They took the first lead, but in the end, things turned around. Jeanette Hegdustad and John Herman Hegg, they do say that sometimes it's harder to keep holding the position of a lead rather than trying to climb up and overturn it, which is exactly what Germany did today. They're just a couple of years younger than Dustad and Hegg, 22 and 23. These youngsters, this is not the last that we're seeing of them. I'm sure we might see them in the individual competition as well. Hegg and Dustad, and both Janssen and Ulbricht. The two youngsters were both at the Youth Olympic Games in Buenos Aires. They weren't at the big senior Olympic Games just yet, as Dustad and Hegg were in Tokyo, both winning the fourth place. And unfortunately, this was not a lucky day for Norway. First, they've lost the gold medal match from Great Britain, and then losing the bronze medal match from Germany. But what can you do? It's the way of the sport. We'll be back soon with the gold medal match. Stay with us as we have India and Great Britain in the run for the top place on the podium. Athletes are going to take their positions now. Align everything right with the targets. Adjust the monitors, adjust everything that they need. Back in the day, as they would say, the targets were not like this, not electronic targets, but paper targets. And the athletes would have to push the paper, of course, mechanically. I mean, there was a system, push the paper 10 meters away and bring it back. You can imagine what a different time that was. But now, with the electronical targets, the data comes in way faster. They can see it on the screen, and then we can see it on the screen. And yeah, the whole thing has a bit of a more dynamic push to it. It's fun to see them get ready as well before they strap in to those jackets and pants and the tight shoes and stand in their super strict position, which it's better and best not to move too much from Here's Shauna McIntosh. She's one of the most successful, if not the most successful, Great Britain rifle shooter right now.
So, ladies and gentlemen, people of Cairo.
That was fast. They were able to set up everything pretty quickly.
Yeah, okay, I know. Again, that was a rehearsal. You weren't loud enough last time. Again, give me another chance to redeem yourself by making more noise for our teams competing in this gold medal match. So get ready, Cairo.
Last couple of calming breaths behind the scenes before they step out on the world stage and show what they've got. India or Great Britain, what is it gonna be? We're just gonna have to wait and see. Here they are, all geared up, walking not as lightly as they did when they were setting up the equipment. 27-year-old Shauna McIntosh. She was awarded by the British Shooting as the Olympic Athlete of the Year 2023. She's accompanied by Dean Bale. He's come close to a final bronze medal match last year in Baku World Cup, but this will be his first one in his career. Then we have 21-year-old Sonam Maskar, but in front of her, walking 25-year-old Arjun Babuta. He's got 2 World Cup golds, but no mixed team for now until today. Today he's definitely getting a mixed team medal. And the question is, which shine? Is it going to be a silver one? Is it going to be a gold medal? So we've seen it now in the bronze medal match, single shots only, except for this preparation time and the sighting time. India has had a couple of actually teams, mixed teams opting. This was India's second team that got into the gold medal match, and Great Britain's only team to get into the gold medal match. India's first team was Nancy and Patil. They ended up in the 20th place, actually. And there was 38 teams total that tried out to end up here. And the final hall, under the big, great big light of the world shine.
If you're just joining us, this is the gold medal match. 10 meter air rifle mixed team event here at the ISSF World Cup Cairo 2024.
So Sonam Maskar, this is her first World Cup final appearance. And Arjun Babuta, he's won a quota for India at the last at the Asian Championship in Changwon last year.
And if you're new to this event, because
So we've seen him more than once, that's for sure. That was Fatnik. He's the Indian coach. Allowed to call for a timeout whenever there's a need. We did have an interesting situation already yesterday with the new Indian athlete coming up. No data on her, anything. She's 33 and actually won the silver medal. Shauna McIntosh. She's had a great season last year, winning 2 World Cups. Baku with the 50-meter 3 position, and here actually in Cairo for the 10-meter air rifle. That was truly an amazing final. That was really actually a year ago exactly, I would say, in maybe it was February though, when she was shooting that final. And Dean Bale, 26. The jury in charge, this is Naha, Egypt. So Great Britain had a great situation coming in out of the qualifications. They were able to score a place in the gold medal match. India was better by almost one whole point. So India had 632.3 and Great Britain had 631.4. Now the audience audience is taking a photo. Again, it's a full house today. Two of the presidents of the Egyptian Shooting Federation and the African Shooting Federation as well, and the ISSF president here. I mentioned them already in the bronze medal match. But now, of course, this is the grand finale, the gold medal match. The athletes are in for it. They still have another minute and a half to get into the zone. From what I'm seeing from down here, they're doing pretty good. Seeing some 10.6s and 10.7s, which means they are ready to go in. Here's the chief range officer, Mr. Fuchs. He's going to be the chief range officer for every final here for rifle and pistol. Don't ask him about shotgun, though. Although I think he would find his way around it. We'll be in the shotgun range later on today with Trap Men and Trap Women event. So if you're a fan of that too, come back and watch it with us. It's a pretty tight schedule today. 4 finals and we're only at the first one, with the gold medal match being just in front of us. Next up it's gonna be the air pistol mixed team events. Again, the same order, bronze medal match and then the gold medal match. End of preparation now. The chief range officer has called it. India and Great Britain will be battling out. For the top place on the podium. Mixed team event is only for air rifle, air pistol, and there's a skeet mixed team event as well. But that's on the shotgun range, so you're going to have to join us there in the days to come. Let's focus on what's in front of us.
Stop.
First round, Great Britain starting off with 21.0. I think I already mentioned that. That's a pretty good score to have. And pretty promising to win some points. So, the first 2 points go to Great Britain in the bronze medal match. The first two went to Norway, and they finished in the fourth place in the end. So that doesn't really say much just yet. They've only taken the first lead. Dean Bale. Some slim tens are going around. A 9.5 from Mascar. That's going to leave them with no points. Another two for Great Britain. Dean Bale, he did win a bronze medal at the Air Rifle Mixed Team event at the ISSF Grand Prix in Osijek last year. But this is definitely the first time he is competing for a mixed team event at the World Cup. Twenty-one-year-old Mascar shoots a 10.7, which is a pretty great shot. Might just get India. Yeah, gets them the first 2 points. It's Mascar's first time appearing at the World Cup in the finals. And it was two strong tens that got India to win the first 2 points. They didn't let Great Britain go too far away, even though in the beginning it looked like they might. But I think we've learned by now things turn around very quickly when it comes to the mixed team events. And also, they're only shooting one round at a time, so it really depends. You know, sometimes you can win by two, I don't know, a little bit of a slimmer tens, and then sometimes it's so strong results, but yet they don't make it to even 2 points. So it really depends on each and every round. It's a bit of a game of luck even in this way. So now 20.6 for each of the teams. They both win 1 point. We've seen that happen in the bronze medal match, but only when we got to the end of the final, when the tension was the highest. And these two teams are showing that to us already, so we're gonna see. Three to five. Great Britain's in the lead. Dean Bale shoots a 10.9, a bullseye. Really given an opportunity here for McIntosh as she shoots at 10.7. Again, this is what I was just saying. This is a great round for both of these teams, yet it was a better round for Great Britain. Hence, they win the 2 points on account of a strong round. It was almost a perfect score. 21.8 is the highest score that one team can get. And Great Britain was really close, winning 2 points. 50 seconds on the clock. India was first in qualification. They did have that 1 point of a difference between them and Great Britain. Now, in the finals, things are turning around a bit, but that might not be until the very end, because you never know. Good shooting from Bale again. mask her out into a slim 10. That's not going to be helpful for the Indian team. And it's going to be another 2 points for Great Britain, this time on a count of 20.8. I am not surprised. It's timeout for India. Yeah, Great Britain has been on a wave of winning. Definitely was time for India to try and turn that around. We push the stream on their side. They have a minute. They have enough time, and I'm always curious to know what goes on, what changes, and how they get the athletes to, you know, get back in the zone once they've fallen out of it. Definitely, it adds a little bit of this psychological effect when the mixed team is involved, as you can ask for a timeout and talk to your coach, which you cannot do in the individual competition. And it's a team effort. While we're kind of used to a shooting sport being an individual sport, so this changes things a little bit. 3-9. Will things change around for the Indian team after this timeout? Ooh, 9.7 out for Bale. Stop. They've definitely thrown them out for this round. At least 2 points go to India on account of 0.4 of a difference in a score, which is pretty comfortable difference. And it happened mostly because of that 9.7 from Bale, but it happens, especially, you know, Bale is shooting right next to the awarded athlete of the British shooting as the Olympic athlete of the year. So it might be intimidating for Dean Bale as well. It hasn't been in a final such as this one of this greatness. And he's managing pretty well. Let's see what he shoots next. It's a 10.4, back into a 10, redeeming himself. 10.8 on the other side, though. That was a tough one. That turned into a tie. Not surprised by that. 20.9. I'm pretty sure it was the same score in the bronze medal match that got a tie. But now, 6-10, two winning rounds are between them. Great Britain's definitely closer to those 16 and to the top of the podium. Another round, another chance for the Indian team to try and come closer to Great Britain. .7 from Bale. That might be just enough. McIntosh and Mascot, it's all on her right now. Unfortunately, that wasn't enough, even though Mascot did shoot a nice, firm 10. The 2 points go to Great Britain as they're approaching 16. More and more, see, Bale has had his ups and downs in the stats. He's went up to the highs and down to the lows. There's three rounds of a difference between the two teams. So to come to a tie, India would need to win three rounds in a row. By that time, Great Britain might approach 16, even more. If they win any rounds, 10.3 from Bale. And it almost looked like this was going to be another one of those tied ones. It's a slim, slim difference, 0.2 between India and Great Britain. So Great Britain came to a match point. You can see the stats. McIntosh has been doing the work here. Playing hard and keeping it pretty stable throughout the whole final, throughout every round. This might be a match point for Great Britain, but India still does have a chance here if they turn things around very quickly. It does happen, though. Wouldn't be the first time. .5 from Bale. Looks promising for Great Britain. Out into a 9 by McIntosh. It's not going to be a match point just yet. India had a bit of a space here to get and gain another 2 points. They've come now halfway to 16. So it looks like they're not as far away anymore. It's only 3 rounds that they would need. Babuta, I mean, he was shooting pretty stably, but somewhere on the lower part of the tens. He has had many of those slim tens. They are in the center, they are there, but they're just not as strong as the team would need to catch up. Might be a match point. The tension is rising. The audience is cheering. Ow, out into a 9.8 now. It's Bale this time. McIntosh redeeming the 9 with a 10.7. 20.5 is not the strongest of the rounds, and here we go. Yep. Exactly what happens. 2 points go to India on account of the difference. It's almost half a point in the score. Now, timeout. McIntosh had her 9. Bale had his. I guess the coach is going to ask, is that it? Did you get it out of your system? Can we now try and join forces? Because it's tricky in the mixed team event. It's not only you need to shoot better, but you kind of have to have this synergy with your teammate where you shoot good at the same time. And if you shoot bad, better shoot bad at the same time as well, so that you only lose one round and not two, which happened to Great Britain just right now. But coach is here. I'm sure she knows what to do and how to have them get back in the zone, because they were definitely in the zone from the beginning of this gold medal match. And it's time, and we're back at it. Another match point situation for Great Britain. They've been here 2 rounds in a row.
For the next
Still chance for India. They are breathing down Great Britain's neck. Great Britain is not doing so great. Mascar needs a 10.2 or higher. She hits a 10.4. Now they're coming dangerously close to Great Britain. It's three rounds in a row. It's exactly what I mentioned that they needed, and it's what they've done. So, another one and they would be tied, unless Great Britain cuts the cord here, finds a way. Could be a match point. I'm sure Bale is going to shoot first. 9.8. They really squeezed them hard. 10.4 from McIntosh. Oscar needs another slim 10 over here, and that's going to be a tie. This is a tie. Four rounds in a row, won by India. They're pushing on Great Britain. I'm sure this is not easy for Great Britain. The pressure is all on them, as they were the ones who were winning. They were the ones who were so close to the end, so close to the finish line. And they tripped. They just tripped, and India took that momentum and has been rolling with it ever since. Four rounds in a row. It's really amazing what they've done. It didn't look so positive for the Indian team. But now, it's a match point for both. Now, it's a moment where they are completely tied and equal. .1 from Bale. McIntosh is not letting this situation get out of hand, at least not on her, and it's gonna be a match point in the end for Great Britain. I mean, what a moment to hit a 10.9. It's not strange that she was awarded by the British shooting as the Olympic athlete of the year, because when things get really serious, she makes it out 10.9 and wins the gold with Dean Bale. What a great comeback from India, but then in the end, Great Britain really didn't let that happen, but it was one of the more amazing finals with the Indians. They really showed their strength here. They were back. Then they win four rounds in a row to get to a tie. That was just hard to continue on after that, looks like it. Can't really win on every field. Sara Mascar and Arjun Babuta, I think we're gonna see them just now. The teams are congratulating each other. And they're gonna have a victory ceremony soon, because right after this, the air pistol mixed team event at 12:30. So that's in half an hour. But stay here. We still have a medal ceremony and a tight, tight schedule today. Germany with the bronze, India with the silver, and Great Britain with the gold of the season opener ISSF World Cup in Cairo, Egypt 2024.
McIntosh and Dean Bale. So congratulations once again to our medal winning teams, and also to Norway as well, who took fourth place in this final. We'll have the medal ceremony for this event very soon, in just a few moments in fact, over at the podiums in the finals hall. So stay where you are, and after that the action continues. We'll have the 10 meter air pistol mixed team event. So lots more to come, Cairo. Don't you go anywhere. Don't you dare.